Hello, and welcome back to The Sim. In this one, we're jumping into Microsoft 2024, and we're going to look at SPAD.neXt and a new feature that was released called vDECK, or Virtual Deck. We're going to use the Platus PC12 from SWS, and we're going to look at making ourselves an overhead panel. So let's go ahead and jump inside. We want to go ahead and build one of these as a virtual device, which we can then place anywhere we like via a web browser. Instead of jumping in how to build it, let's actually show you it operating and how that works. So I have my virtual deck that I've gone ahead and laid out the overhead panel in the PC12. Now what's really cool is there is a detach button, and this is going to allow us to quickly open this inside of a web browser. We literally have a vDECK set up. And this uses some very simple HTML. You can edit the HTML if you want to get more out of it. So here inside of the sim, you can see we've got our overhead panel. And just like we have here, we have the ability to go ahead and turn on the virtual items, move the switches, and they move inside of the sim. We can turn on our recog lights, we can turn those on in the sim, and vice versa. If we were to go into the sim and turn on and off our lights, we can see that our overhead panel is reflecting that. So here inside of SPAD.neXt, in my panels, you'll see I have a vDECK that I created. Now, a vDECK is very much like a StreamDeck XL. So on my StreamDeck XL, I had created different sections of the overhead panel because only so many things can fit. And so what I wanted to do is be able to build an overhead panel that I could run from a touchscreen that will be mounted as an overhead. So for this, I have a vDECK and I called it a 14x6. Very original name, I know, but my vDECK is basically 14 buttons by 6 rows. So 14 columns, 6 rows. And that allowed me to create the layout that I needed to apply some separation to give myself that kind of similar layout as to what we see in the overhead panel of the PC12. Every single one of these buttons is built as a Guage button. So you absolutely can download Stream Decks. So Stream Deck layouts that have been created and published as online snippets, you can go ahead, download those, and they apply instantly. It uses the same coding, so you create a button gauge. So here, for this, you'll see that we created a background layer. I created a Garmin gray layer, so it's an image layer, and then I used the online image database that has all kinds of different images. And then we used that image as a background because then I wanted to shrink the switch down a little bit. I was using one of these switches, and then it allowed me to go ahead and put a text layer over top. So this was a very quick way to make a multi-layered switch, and then that way I could copy and paste it afterwards. Here, we're setting the battery to 0 and 1, but it's both short presses, and we were gating it based on what the current AVAR is, prior to us getting those the ability to set a toggle event. So I could go back through, now that it's Microsoft 2024, and replace all of these, needing to validate what the position of the switch was in, as to whether it's setting it on or off. Now we could go in and replace this with the underscore toggle event and only need the one event. Then you'll see that we are changing the image, so I can, when the value of the battery is a 0, I'll set the switch to off, and when the value is a 1, I set the switch to on. So you can look in other videos that we've posted. Those will show you how to use dev mode to use the behaviors tab, control G over top of a switch, and then you can track down what variables and events are used on a button or switch. So go ahead, there's a link to that video. A lot of times we're just changing the image back and forth. So here, for example, with the cooling, the cooling or the vents, you could see that we can change the image. And so depending on what state the variables are in, it's going to change the image. And here you could see that we are just using a single toggle to toggle the event. Plus, It is a multi-state condition, so circuit 9 will tell the system that it has electricity. So when that's a 0, it's going to make the button blank so that it shows neither the recycling or the cool. And of course, if we turn the system off, those arrows are going to go out as well. So when it doesn't have anything on circuit 9. So yeah, that's how that works. If we look at the button gauge, you'll see we've got these little mini titles. But the button blank, we use the button itself. So I just captured the state of the button with the arrows. So it allowed me to kind of rebuild the button without having to capture every single button. I captured some arrows, up and down position, and blank, and then it was easy. And then we created some titles, so that allowed us to put things where we needed to. We even have the little title lines. We went and put a line in there. So basically recreating those buttons. You could build whatever you would have built on a physical Stream Deck, you can now build as HTML pages. When we detach it, you'll see it automatically launches it in a web browser and it's gonna send it to this position. And it's this vDECK. So we know that it's on 2801. This computer is .201. That will also load it. So as you can see, this is the IP address that I would use from an external device. So if I was using my iPad, I would just connect to 10.01.201 because it's on the same Wi-Fi network, and as long as it can reach this port, 28.0.0.1, I'm now gonna be able to open this device. So to create one of these devices, you go to the plus, you come to your virtual devices. Now this does require that you have either complete edition or a standard edition with the virtual add-on, so like virtual FIPS. So if you come to your settings and you came to registration and you wanted to add an add-on, that would be the vFIP. So virtual FIP, virtual DEX, so vDECK, virtual Stream DEX, when you add that to a standard license or if you have the complete edition. So when you come to devices, you will also see under virtual devices, you can also add virtual devices here. So there's two places that you can actually create a virtual device. You can do it from the plus or you can do it here. They effectively do the same thing. Now under application settings, under web, you do have to have the web enabled. So that's the webs, the web sockets, the REST API, all that has to be enabled. And this is the port that you're gonna use to connect to it on, with that vDECK ID as to which one of your vDECKs it is. And then here you'll see enable access for virtual FIP. So we need this, so virtual devices. So vFIP, vDECKs, all those need this to be on. And then also web access from remote. So if you have this set to off, only local computer will be able to access it on the local host. If you have it set to on, it will be able to access it via the IP address. We come over to the plus, we come to our virtual devices, or we did it in devices, and we are going to add a virtual device. And you'll see here, you can add a vFIP or you can add a vDECK. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna add a vDECK. So when we're adding a vDECK, you're gonna see that you can enter the number of rows. And so if we wanted to make a vDECK that matched a Stream Deck XL, that's gonna be 4 rows and 8 columns. So 4 rows of 8 buttons. So we'll go ahead and click OK, and we have now created this device. You're also gonna see something that comes up that says some changes configuration will become active after restarting. So we're gonna click OK, because when we come back over to here, you're gonna see that our other vDECK is not yet available. So like a lot of things with SPAD.neXt, when you make big configuration changes, you have to close SPAD.neXt and launch it again. So let's go ahead and do that. So now that SPAD's up and running again, we're gonna head back over to our panels, and now we can see our other vDECK has now become available. And if we hit the detach button, it'll launch it in a browser, and you can see this one is labeled vdeck0002.html. So pretty simple naming, but that is how you find it. So now if we look at the device settings and we were to rename the device, you'll see it's called vDECK. So we could name this vDECK_8x4. Sure. Now we've renamed it. Let's go to our Stream Deck. Let's go to Copy, Complete Device. And now let's go back to our vDECK. And let's go ahead and paste. And yes, we want to replace everything. We can detach this one. And of course, we go to this one and we can detach it. And I can drag these out and make them obviously into two totally different tabs, put them on different displays, put them on different touchscreens. Here, for example, we've got the exact replica of my physical Stream Deck. We can still navigate to those same things. So I can go to that overhead main. I can control the battery. Battery's going off. We can see everything working exactly the same. Now I've got my autopilot control. So I can go ahead and control that from here. So again, if you want to run these, you got to remember you need 0.9.23.31. And you need to be using either a complete license or on a standard license, you have the virtual FIP and virtual Stream Deck add-on. That's gonna go ahead and do it for this one. If you made it this far, please hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't, and come along on the next one. As always, thanks for watching. Have a great day.